August office of the President of the Republic of India, which you have adorned the last 5 years with great distinction and dignity. This is indeed a solemn occasion for each one of us to express our profound respect and regards to you. Honorable President, your life's journey from the humble village of Mirati in West Bengal to Rashtrapati Bhavan is indeed an eventful one entwined with contemporary history of our nation and an inspiration to all. Beginning professional career as a college teacher, then journalist, and subsequently dedicating the longest period of your life to national politics, culminating in being elected as the president, you have always strived for excellence and selfless service. Your achievements as a political leader, parliamentarian, administrator, author, and visionary thinker are a grand testimony of your multifaceted personality. Mahoday, ever since you first entered the parliament in 1969, you have enriched and strengthened our parliamentary democracy with varied expertise, vast contribution, and great wisdom. You have always held the institution of parliament and its traditions in the highest regard and upheld the dignity and decorum of both the houses. Sagacious and yet courteous to friends and political opponents alike, you have earned the respect of all with your disarming persuasive skills, intellectual farsightedness, and unwavering commitment to the basic tenets of parliamentary democracy and political pluralism. You are respected for your impeccable knowledge of constitutional and parliamentary rules and procedures and exemplary memory of events and precedents. You have been a guru from whom generations of parliamentarians have received lessons on the operational dynamics of our parliamentary polity. You very aptly, the parliamentary fraternity conferred the Outstanding Parliamentarian Award on you for the year 1997. Your admirable administrative acumen and efficiency have played a pivotal role in shaping appropriate responses to various momentous events and challenges before the nation at large. As Union Cabinet Minister, holding key portfolios and also occupying crucial decision-making positions, your rich contributions in laying down policies leading to the progress of this nation will be remembered and cherished for times to come. Your astute diplomatic skills have served the nation well, whether as a minister handling the responsibility of external affairs or serving on the board of governance of international and multilateral financial institutions. A grateful nation has conferred the second highest civilian award to you, the Padma Vibhushan, in 2008. You have deservingly received acclaims from the people at home and abroad and earned numerous honors from universities far and wide in recognition of your contributions. With your thoughtfulness and wisdom, you brought dignity and respect to the august office of the President, which gained new prominence as political leaders of all hue and affiliations sought your guidance on crucial matters affecting the nation.